Got a nigga faded. Shorty on fire. Is she really blazing? Flames, I'ma get it. Yelling, Jesus save me. I'ma take a soul. If she try to play me, cause that's all mine. I am here. I'm in no light. Hold on. Like the fucking 80s. Throwing up the room. Like a nigga. Just over in this part of the room. Coming back. I'm coming back. The fucking dishwasher, not the dishwasher. The clothes are in the fucking washing machine. My work stuff.
I gotta hang that up. It's Rocket Man with a 262 at the end. Bro, I wish I was a performer on that. I wonder how you get to be a performer. Do you think I could, like, just ask them? Do you think I could say... I'd probably have to go to their studios, don't I? Do you think I can somehow get on a can show? Because then I would just ignore him. I would answer everyone but him. I would literally answer everyone but him. I'd be like, yeah, hi, Big Cat Daddy, how you doing? Yeah, let's show her arse off for Big Cat Daddy. And I'd make the girl show her arse on that. And then Derek would be like, can you say my name when you do reverse cowgirl? And I'd be like, right, guys, anyone want any sex positions? The only one we're not doing today is reverse cowgirl. We don't like that, it's rubbish. I actually don't mind that. I don't like it when they're just sitting on you. I don't like it when you're laying down and the lady's facing away. That's rubbish. I like it when your legs are like up, so you're holding like underneath their hips here, so you can like do stuff. Right, don't worry about that. But that's what I would do. That's what I would do. Right, I need an ashtray. Yeah, he would. Good. Creepy little Kuma Khan. Well, the Epo can's gonna go out of sync with my voice. Do you know what? I don't give a fuck. Where's the ashtray? I just fucking had it, bro. Oh, what? I literally just had the ashtray, bro. I mean, I had it like not even 5 minutes ago. Where'd I've misplaced it? Oh, God's sake. Bro, I literally just tipped it out. Right, wait there. Oh, so we had, whoa. Mr. Lion, Rocket Man. Oh. How we doing? I'm gonna try not to fall asleep this street. Right, how we doing? I trained shoulders today. I worked. We didn't have a hard day. I worked and then I trained shoulders this morning. They were absolutely annihilated. My shoulders were annihilated today. Oh my goodness. But then I was laying here and I was like, why don't I do a stream? I'm maybe gonna do one later. I finished the fucking final station, hang on. I finished the final station. But then I was like, what else am I gonna do? So I've got Crisis later, maybe. Might do Crisis later. Might do, I don't know. There was something else I wanted to play as well. But if I do a stream, it'll be like another short thing because I've got work again tomorrow. But I can fit it all in. Final Station was awesome. I thought it was gonna take me a bit longer. But it didn't, and I destroyed it, and I basically saved everyone. Did I beat Atomic Heart? Oh God, something here is gonna go mad. No, not yet. I'm on the last boss. I'm at the last boss. I'm literally at the last boss. La, 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 la. Right. Good game. Good game, fun game. DSP should be playing that. He should just got on with it. Hard. Tricky game. DSP should have just got on with it. Bro, I feel so stiff today. I feel really stiff today. This arm, I've got that weird tendonitis, like sort of strain in here from too much gripping and doing stuff. Gun show, fuck. Let's go, bro. I didn't used to look like this. I promise you, I didn't used to look like this. We'll show it once more for posterity's sake. Is that the word, posterity? I think that's the word. Bro, look. From that to this. From that to this. Quite the transformation, yeah? It only took me 10 years. I think posterity is the word, but, you know, content maybe and stuff like that. It only took me 10 years. It's O. Everyone else calls him O, so that's what I call him now. It's his fault he's got loads of stupid lines in his fucking name. And I don't know what to call him. But now his name's fucking O. I've decided. Everyone else says that. It's easier. Is it right? I don't know. Oh my God, Tina. Tina. This is a hip hinge. Remember that really tricky move I said I was going to show you? Right? This is perfect. I can't believe I remembered this. Right. Let's move me closer to the edge so you can see more. Stay there, you cunt. Okay. Okay, right? So, instead of just bending over, look, see my back's bending? We don't want no arch like that. We also don't just want to be straight, right? So we're gonna hinge at the hip. The hip is the hinge, right? My torso is one half of the hinge. My upper thighs are the other half of the hinge. The actual join part is my hips, right? So my ass goes this way. My ass goes black and it keeps going back and I keep hinging. These go back. My torso goes back, look, like a hinge. But my shin stays the same. So the more I push, the more my hamstrings and my glutes stretch. Like I'm trying to stick my ass that way as far as possible. And I'm trying to hinge and fold my torso onto my legs here. So if you imagine the barbells beneath me, if you're doing it right, you can pick the weight up and the weight should stay in exact the same place. My fingers should touch the exact same place on the floor every time. They don't move forward, they don't move back. So I just push back, I hinge, I stretch as much as I can into my hamstrings. And I come back, I hinge, and I come back. People kind of lock their legs down and go like this. Like it's quite a stretch, but it will hurt, like it's not quite the same. So we hinge, we come back. That's how you do it. That's how you do a hip hinge. Carlo with the 69 bits. It's hard, you'll get it. Thanks very much, Carlo, for the 69 bits. Oh, did the animation play? We're talking about a move called a hip hinge, where you're gonna do Romanian deadlifts or stiff legs. Some people call them stiff leg deadlifts. You'll get it. It's hard to do originally. Everyone just starts to like, everyone thinks like they just keep really tight and have to bend over. It's hard to think about hinging, like doing that. So you stretch like, when I get to here, I can feel the stretch in my hamstrings now. Like when you overextend the joint, or like when you pull like that and you feel a stretch in your shoulder, Once I get to about here, I can feel the stretch in my hamstrings. But yeah, it's tricky. And they're just an awkward move. But they're effective, that's the thing. It's awkward, but it's effective. But how are you doing, Tina? I knew I'd get a chance to show you in the end. Oh, fuck. I did shoulders today. Lads, I got on the hammer strength shoulder press. That's like, not, it's plate loaded, but it's straight up. It's not the same as the one at my gym. I put 120 kilos on this thing. But I got 10 reps. Then I put 140 on it. And I got 5. Or did I get 7? Whatever. I put 140 kilos on it to finish my set. To finish my, you know, whatever. It was fucking heavy. And I talked to an old guy in the gym. 58 he was. Like, bit of a belly on him, but thick arms, big shoulders, like, he was strong, and I was training, and then I was on a machine next to him, and he said hello, and we're talking. I asked him how long he'd been training. He's talking about, you know, keeping fit as he gets older. He says, oh yeah, and then he said to me, do you use gear? And I went, yeah, I do. And he goes, yeah, I use like, and he started telling me, this old lad, like 58 years old, started telling me what steroids he takes. And he wasn't like taking loads of steroids, he just takes like testosterone for as he gets older. But like, to look at him, he looked great, but he's just a normal gym goer. He looked like someone's dad in the gym, like a bit of a swole, just a normal guy. Not the sort of guy you would expect to then ask you, oh, do you use steroids? And start telling you like, oh yeah, I use this, blah, 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 blah. Bro, everyone's taking steroids. I didn't know. Can you see my washing machine shaking? Can you see that? You can probably hear it. I thought it was only a few people, but apparently a lot of people are dabbling, young and old. But I had a good workout, that's the main thing. Then I came home. I laid on the bed for a little while. I was up early and I streamed last night. Bro, I always stream at night. And then I go, okay, another 4.5 hours sleep. Carlo at the gun show. Let's go. Oh, nice. So you went for pink in the end. I mean, I don't know why I would think pink is the best color. I wonder why pink is the best color here. You know, I wonder why all the cool people probably have pink in their hair, don't they? I've actually got a pink tattoo there as well. I've got this little thing here is pink. I wish I had a bit more. I've got some pink in this, and I've got some pink in that as well, but not loads. I wanted more. I am Carlo. I am getting bigger. Slowly. We're slowly getting bigger. Very, very slowly. Calmly, you know? I'm getting bigger calmly. Are we doing the watch tonight? Maybe. The time is different though. The time is different. It's not 1 a.m. my time anymore, it's midnight because of daylight savings. So it's midnight my time. If we do it, it'll be midnight my time. So maybe tonight we'll hang out and we'll fucking wreck that creepy little cunt Derek again. Fucking scumbag. He's a proper scumbag. I don't care that he's a little bit like, you know, he's not quite the full ticket. That's not the point. I've said this. The point is that because his whole life is just masturbating and porn and doing his weird attention things, if he was to proper lose the plot or be out in public, I could honestly, you could honestly see him either try to inappropriately touch someone, inappropriately approach someone, be opportunistic. I don't think it's mad to say that whatsoever. I don't think it's. I've got to hang that up. That's my work clothes. I don't think it's that's unlikely or odd to say whatsoever. Creepy little fucking scumbag. Metal Mike, so how you doing, bro? You were playing Bloodborne the other day. Did you beat DS2 and DS3? Sometimes when I lurk on your stream, it's a different time. I'm up working or whatever. And you was doing DS2, but then when I see the other day, you was doing Bloodborne. Did you beat DS2 and DS3? Bloodborne's great. Bloodborne's got quite a lot of secret content. Well, there's a lot of stuff you have to do to get the true ending. If you want my advice, sadly not real hard. He beat him, very cool, bro. Sadly not real hard. Big ups real hard, by the way. Sadly not. Rehan, you seem like the sort of man that has resources. Maybe we're playing it offline. I come to you. You drive. I'll restrain him. And we'll drive him out into the woods, yeah? And talk to him. I feel like that's the sort of secret Rehan could take to his grave. I think Rehan's got those stone cold dead killer eyes. You know? We'll just talk to him. But Metal Mike, if you want my advice, he earned it. Yeah, like Casino. Vinny Kills, how you doing? Metal Mike, even though it won't really spoil you, but look up online how to get the true end boss. The last boss in Bloodborne is called the Moon Presence. I won't tell you what it is, and I won't tell you anything about it. But to get it, you got to do some weird shit. But that's like the true ending of the game. And you can miss some other stuff during the game if you don't do it.
One nigga run to the front.
Do I have to work in the rain? It depends. How about I start shooting? Today we did. Oh, let's have a look at Tina's Pink Mohican. By the way, Captain and Boone, how you doing? It depends. Today we did because we were just doing turfing. So we had started, we was at a job we had started yesterday. We did their back garden last year, but they didn't do the grass. They said, we're gonna do the grass next year after the winter, whatever. So we went back and did soil and then turf. And even though it was raining this morning, it weren't torrential. It was raining a bit, but not enough. So we were just like, let's just fucking do it. So we got it done. But if it's like cement and stuff, we can't do in the rain because you can't. Like when you see pointing, like if you see like tiles laid on the floor and they've got that bead of concrete between where it's like a little line like that, that's called pointing, stuff like that, and doing certain types of concrete and cement, you can't because the rain like gets in puddles and ruins it and it don't dry properly. So some things we can't. Oh my God. Oh my goodness, look at this. When is this? 2012. Look at that, it's a pro photo as well, so it looks even better. Look at this. Bro, that ain't Tina. That ain't Tina. You stole someone's photo. Bro, look at that. Did you used to do modelling then, or did you just get pictures done? I always thought about doing something like that, or I have thought about doing stuff like this, given how I look. But I've never really pursued anything like, even like, OnlyFans was as far as I got. OnlyFans was as far as I got. Am I playing RE4? Has it come out today? Bro, everyone's asking about Resident Evil 4. Landscaping in the rain is no good. Yeah, standard. Everyone's asking about fucking RE4. Everyone really looking forward to that game, are they? I take it everyone's really looking forward to that. I'm going to shut up about what I think about the Resident Evil remakes. You did modelling for Japanese punk brands. So like what, just like clothing? So you just wear like crop tops and like those like angry mini skirts where they have the sort of studded belt and like fishnets and just do modelling for their website. Pretty cool. I've played the old one. The demo is good. Listen, okay, listen. I like, right, I'm gonna do a DSP thing with you. You know when DSP like goes, allow me to give you some perspective on this. And he goes, 10 years ago, and he tells some story, right? Back in the day, Little Marked, at age probably like 7 or something, goes to his cousin's house. Take it easy, Carlo. Thank you for the 69 bits. Little Mark goes to his cousin's house. It's nice to see you, Carlo, by the way. Have a good day, whatever you're doing. He goes to his cousin's house, and his cousin has a PlayStation 1. And what game has his cousin just bought on the PlayStation 1? Resident Evil. And we sit there, and he goes, my cousin was older than me, like 14 or something. And he's showing me, he's like, look, it's so creepy. And I was watching the cutscenes, like, the bit with the first zombie and then the dog corridor. And then like a few years later, I watched a bunch of it with him. I was too young to play it. A few years later, I got a PlayStation or a PS2. And through friends and myself as well, I played Resident 1, 2, 3, Nemesis. And then I can't remember what number 4 was on, Dreamcast? No, that was Code Veronica. But I played all those old ones back in the day. I played them all. And I like the remakes, but whenever I play a remake, I sit and think to myself, okay, I get remastering a game, but I'm literally playing GameCube. There you go, my mate at school had that, because my mate at school, I played that with, and we played Code Veronica as well. But I sit there and now, and I play them, and I think these are really good, but why didn't they make a new game? I go, these are really good. Why didn't they just do another city? Why do we have to relive the old stuff that I already know? And the other thing that stings is because it's Capcom. And Capcom, I know they're making games, but Capcom are fucking lazy, bro. Look, Capcom have done loads of mad shit and microtransactions and all this shit. Capcom are so fucking sus. It is nostalgia. Like, that's what I mean when I say they're lazy. Because there's a built-in... It's like when they do these remake films, and they're all trash. Because you know that... They know that through market research, they go, well, this is how many social media posts there are about this old series. This is how many likes certain things get. We know that if we make a film or game about this, or a remake, it's already going to have an inbuilt audience of 1 million, 2 million, whatever. Doesn't mean I think they're shit. I just think I wish I was playing another third-person Resident Evil game. Well, REA, I like Resident Evil and Resident Evil. Like, Resident Evil 7 and 8, I like. But the thing is, they just called them Resident Evil and put Chris in it just because, like, it popularity, because they were too scared to just make a game called Village. I don't know why they didn't just... like make them a separate game and lean into making a first person horror game. Yeah, you're not wrong, Metal Mike. They go, oh, it's Resident Evil, I have to buy it. You're not wrong. Do you know why that is? Because there's too much money involved. There's so much money involved now. Years ago, they were innovating more because they were trying to be the next big thing. That still happens now, but you also get a lot of these companies that are like stuck in time. Most of the new stuff sucks. There's a bit of that too. Greed is massively strong. You're not wrong, Perez, by the way, how you doing? A lot of the new stuff does suck. And it's boring and it's safe, you know? It's boring and it's safe. But it's just what the industry has become. I read somewhere that gaming, quote unquote, was valued. I don't know how they value these industries, but it's bigger than film. Yeah, new adaptations of old movies or the 50th sequel because the character was popular 10 years ago and they just milk it to death. They just cut its throat, hang it up and bleed it for absolutely everything it's got. And then once it's like completely like shriveled husk, they go, okay, what do we do next? Yeah, it's kind of, I don't know about rare, but yeah, new things are seemingly harder to come by. Like Ubisoft has made the same game for the last 15 years, it feels like to me. They've just packaged it under a bunch of different names. Well, it should have become an industry because when you have an industry such as this and it's so big, you do get amazing games and you get innovation. If gaming wasn't an industry, games like Elden Ring don't exist. If gaming wasn't this giant industry, games like Red Dead 2 don't exist. Games are still niche. And they're still like a nerdy thing, and you get football games and Call of Duties and things like that, but these big RPGs, it's not even just RPGs, these other things that come out of the woodwork don't exist because there's not as much money to be had. So even though people are chasing money and popularity and they're trying to innovate sometimes, it also allows a lot of stagnation. It's what they call a double-edged sword. Oh. Other good things would have existed, but there just wouldn't have been, like, again, change and all this stuff drives the innovation. There's no need to innovate if there's no hunger for it. If there's no reason to innovate, there'd be no need. The growing audience and the increase in numbers and profit is still one of the driving factors in why, or was one of the driving factors, I guess, but shot gaming into, like, it went from just like a nerdy thing that loser little boys do, which is kind of still viewed like that now, but to like a global thing. Elden's amazing. It's one of my favourite games ever. It's my favourite From Software game. Elden Ring is amazing. And big games would have still been around. But unfortunately, without the sort of exposure and what we've got now, they would have been few and far between anyway. But again, it also opens the door for a lot of useless shit, shovelware, you know. It's both. Sadly, it's both. But Elden Ring exists, so I wouldn't change anything. I wouldn't change the scenario because Elden Ring exists. And Elden Ring is great. I could potentially go and play a bit of Crysis in a minute. Like a tiny little bit of Crysis 2. Like a tiny little bit. Fortnite, I'm trash at Fortnite. Would it exist if games never became an industry? Again, probably not. If gaming isn't an industry, a game like Dark Souls isn't as popular, finds a niche audience, but isn't as popular. You don't have a whole genre of things called Souls-likes because there's not millions and millions of people who want to play a difficult game like that. It's a real tight-knit thing. And then that company, From Software, because of all these other companies making games like them and making them push the boat and these other RPGs, don't feel the need to say, we need to build a giant open world game and try and put our stamp on it, make it sick. Or at least if those things happen, it would happen much, much slower. They would just bring out good Dark Souls games, and if they sold well and it was a niche thing, then they would keep doing that. It's not that people don't want to innovate, but changing and all this sort of stuff drives it. You weren't compelled to try getting over it again. No. No. I actually hate that game. I actually hate that game. Like, not... Every time I see someone playing it, I thought you said Elden would exist. That's a good question as well. Because he rode that wave of let's plays and new games and stuff. That's a good question too, probably not. But no, getting over it, every time I see someone play it, I never ever watch that game once and say, this looks fun. That's my issue. I never ever watch it, even if the person's laughing, even if it's a fun stream like yours is. I never ever sit and watch it and think, that looks fun. I never see that game and go, that looks super fun. I go, that looks so fucking annoying that the person that made that is a sadist and I want to hit them with that sledgehammer the dude's holding. That's what I think when I see that game. I see the stupid guy with his sledgehammer and it looks so awkward. Like it looks, again, it's so fucking awkward. I tried it for about 5 minutes. I tried it. My mummy called me. My mummy called me. I had to talk to mum on the phone. But yeah, what was I doing? Oh, I was hating on getting over it, yeah. Garbage gamer, how you doing? I was hating on getting over it. Yeah, it never looks fun. It never looks fun when I see people play it. I played it for literally about 5 minutes and went, fuck this. And every time I see the stupid guy, when you have to awkwardly go to move the thing, I just look at it and go, fuck that. What a dickhead. Even more when I play like Team Ninja games and From Software, when they put like a fucking gank squad that's just there to fucking kill you and I think, you fucking pricks, hiding an enemy right here with like a one-hit kill or whatever. As much as I think that, I think it even more when I see getting over it. And I just look and go, what's the point of this? Why? Why is it so awkward? Why has he got to climb over all this stupid stuff? It's not difficult. It's beyond that. It's just like luck and annoyance. Does it have a lot of reading as well? Like, and again, I've seen people speedrun that in seconds, but that's because a lot of gamers are fucking nerds and autistic as fuck. A lot of us are lunatics. That's why there's a few people out there who can speedrun a game like that. Most of us, that game's shit. Beginner's trap, yeah. Beginner's trap, dude. But yeah. Play Half-Life more, Tina, yeah? Play Half-Life instead. Half-Life 2. And then, Tina, if you have the room, if you have the space indoors, there's a lot of reading in Mass Effect. There's a lot of reading in Mass Effect. It's kind of, and again, a lot of reading on stream. I don't often voice act the characters and stuff. Sometimes I read things out. It's not really me. It's not really my style. But sometimes it can be a bit heavy going to stream games like that as well. But play more Half-Life, right? Play Half-Life. Play Half-Life 2. And then, if you have the space indoors and the money, get a VR headset and play Half-Life Alyx. Half-Life Alyx will... A VR will blow your mind because it's way better than what you think it's going to be. Or at least it was for me. VR was way... When I first played VR, it was like 2015. I think I got HTC Vive, the one I still got now, in 2015. And it blew my mind then. Do it! Just do VR sub goal. Just do it. But yeah, it blew my mind then. I thought, it's going to be fun, but it proper like impressed me. And every time I get it out, it impresses me. It's been around years. I'm sure about 2015, 2016, the original... Let's have a look. Let's have a look when the HTC... Because when it come out, I got it the year or maybe the year after it come out, the HTC Vive. I got it... Let's have a look at when it first come out. First consumer version was in April 2016. So I reckon in 2016, I had the original Vive. But it was proper impressive already. When I played other Vive games, I was already impressed, and there's a bunch of good games. And then I played Half-Life Alyx, and Alyx makes literally every single other VR game that I've ever played, no matter how good it was, look fucking trash. Half-Life Alyx made them all look like tech demos for kids. Half-Life Alyx is a full, like, triple A VR game. Triple A is an awful term, but Alyx is like, it's amazing. It's basically, Valve basically did it again, and it is Half-Life 3, just without it being called that. But Alyx is basically Half-Life 3. And not only that, because it's VR, or it's just because I don't think a lot of people care about Half-Life anymore, but for years, there was talk about Half-Life, and without super spoilers, Gordon Freeman is back. They like revealed Freeman again. So I don't know if they make the next VR game and they're going to call it Half-Life 3. Maybe that is what they're doing. But Alyx is amazing. I know I keep saying this, but seriously, and I've got a dodgy, like an old PC, and my PC can run it like on low settings, and it still looks amazing. I mean, the thing is, without loads of spoilers, Ghost MC, the end of... So, at the end of Half-Life Episode 2, a major character dies, right? And at the end of Alyx, the G-Man changes that event, and that character don't die. And then you look down, and you're basically Freeman. And that's how it ends. So they completely change the end of Episode 2, and then they flat out tell you, in the next fucking game, you're gonna be Freeman. But you're not like, because at the end of Half-Life 1, he sort of disappears you, doesn't he? And it says, await an assignment or something like that. But at the end of it, it was like it was even more. It was even more, at the end of Alyx, it's even more just like, yes, there's more story coming immediately. There's shit going on right fucking now. Bro, I remember playing Portal 2. And you find in episode 2, they talk about that boat thing called the Borealis. I think it's called the Borealis. And it's in the Antarctic somewhere. And that was where episode 3 was gonna be set. And there was some concept art. And then in Portal 2, there's a secret area and you can find the dock because it's the same universe. And it was the area, the boat, like, it like vanished or something. It like disappeared. And you can find the place it was in the Aperture Labs. That's very cool. Portal 1 and 2 are great. They're fucking hard. Well, they're probably not that hard. I just remember, I mean, if I beat them in my early 20s, I could probably do it now with my addled brain. I can do some puzzles pretty fast. Not all. But Half-Life's amazing. Yeah. Half-Life 1 was like... Half-Life 1 and 2 are still up there, aren't they? As like some of the most iconic first-person games ever made. And again, I don't know if Alyx won awards. Like, it should have won Game of the Year. It probably won Best VR Game. It must have done. It must have won. So, bro, I'm telling you, it must have done. It shits on everything on VR I've fucking played. Reenie, how you doing? I see you. It literally, and I'm not, like, it sounds like I work for Valve or something. But it literally shits all over all the other VR games so hard. Like, it's so fucking good. It's so fucking good. Again, it's better than like some triple A what's name games that have come out on that brand new like console, or just current games that have come out. The story's better, the gameplay's better, the atmosphere's better, and it's fucking VR. It's amazing. It's mostly in City 17. It's mostly set in City 17 as well. That's the only thing, you don't go outside, like in Half-Life 2. I mean, to be fair, Half-Life 1 was mostly in the place, but you know, Black Mesa. Well, they're just too busy making it look pretty.
You got it going on. No.
Yeah, you're not wrong. They're always about the mechanics and making sure it was all tight. Has Tina finished Half-Life 1? I think I missed the party because of the streaming time. I think it was late when I was in bed. She might not even be there. She might not even be there. But I think she beat number one, right? Maybe. Yeah, right. What did I win an award for? I won the very suspicious award, the Golden Crab. I didn't get no, like, Golden Award or Barney Award or Black Mace or whatever. I got the Golden Crab. The fuck's that? What the fuck's the Golden Crab? What does that mean? What does that mean? For, like, services to crabs or something? I'm scared. Oh, this is a good song. This is Timescape. This is a good song. Probably. Also, how out of sync am I with the camera? I might have to, like, reset the camera or something. I don't know what makes it go out of sync, but it does. All right, I'll take it. We were literally browsing Twitch one day. It looks synced, all right, sweet. I think someone had probably done one of the redeems where I look in the hot tub stream and we go and just mess around and browse the streams and see what insane shit people are doing on Twitch. And then I remember I'd either said about it or I just said, we're gonna go into the fitness directory, because a lot of the time people in there aren't doing fitness stuff. And we were going through, and I went, look, that girl's got kettlebells or something. She's actually doing something. And clicked on you. And we watched you for a bit and it was all cool. And the rest is history. It's like, she's actually doing fitness stuff. And there was a cat. And then you started playing like random games, all sorts of games. Pretty cool. Golden Freeman, because he bought you the game. Yeah, I mean, it's great. Half-Life 1 is a classic, and you have now beaten it. A classic, classic game from back when gaming was fucking niche and for nerds, and it was huge even back then. It was amazing. Even back then. Yeah, well, do you know what else as well? It annoyed me. I went to look. I haven't got an original 360 anymore. But when the 360 was out, they released this thing called the Orange Box, which was basically Half-Life 2, the two expansions they made for Half-Life 2, and then Portal 1 and Team Fortress, or Team Fortress 2. And they brought it out. I think they probably brought it out for PC as well, but they brought it out for Xbox. So on the Xbox, I'd already played Half-Life 2 on the PC, but then on the Xbox 360, I played Half-Life 2, both Episode 1 and 2, and Portal. Bro, I did all of the achievements. Listen to me. Back in the day, I did every single fucking achievement for Half-Life 2, Episode 1 and Episode 2, including getting all the antlion grubs without a guide. Yeah? Getting all the antlion grubs without a guide. okay? And taking that fucking gnome in episode 2, getting the gnome with the gravity gun and carrying it through half the fucking game and putting it in the satellite thing at the end and launching him into space. Half-Life episode 2 had some mad achievements. On the Xbox in general, the Half-Life games had some fucking wild achievements, bro. All speedrunners are mental. Literally, those people are insane. Those people are insane. If those people were born 1,000 years ago and they were that good at something, people would lock them up and accuse them of witchcraft. Do you know what I mean? Like, that's how crazy those speedrunners are. They're just fucking wired, bro. Getting over it, speedrunner, no. Don't listen to Lodrake. Even though Lodrake is amazing, and Lodrake can basically speedrun a bunch of games, never talks about it, just does it for fun. Like, Lodrake can literally turned on Dark Souls 2 and beat it, no deaths, no bonfires. Just because he could. No deaths, no bonfires. Just one morning, just like, whatever. Fucking around. Anxiety. World famous anxiety, how you doing? You ever played the Half-Life? I will just buy them then. Oh. Buy them. Buy them and fucking play them. I've got Black Mesa, like the remake of number one, but it don't run very well. And my PC's not that shit, but it runs like crap. I tried it once and it run like shit because I was going to stream it. And I tried it just like a little bit before the stream and it run like shit. And I was like, oh, I can't stream it like this. I'm going to have to sort this out. But then just streamed other stuff and never opened it up again. So at some point, I've got to run it, look at the stuff. Because I never try and run them with abusive settings either. Because I don't want to fuck the PC.
Bob Paris. The superb athlete.
Thank you for the follow, Soup Simon. The spring sale starts. Yeah, bro, just get it. Come on, son.
He's getting the crowd going again.
Half-Life, you've got to play Half-Life 1 and Half-Life 2 at least. If you like them, there's expansions. There's our story-based expansions for both. I would particularly encourage you to play the two story expansions for Half-Life 2, Episode 1 and 2, because they're fantastic. There was nothing like it in terms of gameplay. And even the story was amazing. At the time, the physics, you're right. And the level design, everything. That thing where you first go to like Ravenholm and it's this creepy abandoned part of the fucking thing where everyone's turned into a zombie and you got this gravity gun and you're like killing them with like things that are in the environment and shit. The atmosphere, bro, it was so fucking good. The atmosphere for the Half-Life games is like 11 out of 10. It's literally, for most of the fucking game, it's 11 out of 10. Particularly Half-Life 2. It's like literally perfect. And then you have like vehicles and stuff. And a bunch of gameplay segments with that. There was a little bit of like exploration, or you could at least stop and do things. Like the bit where you're in the car or the buggy and you're going along the coast. And you can stop in the houses if you want and shit like that. But what are those magnet mines that just turn up and get you as well? And they roll after you and you got to fucking fire them away with the gravity gun. Fantastic. In Alex, you have a gravity gun, but it's not exactly. You're wearing these gloves, because you play as her, and you're wearing these gloves. I can't remember if he calls them gravity gloves. I think so. But what you can do... You can't throw things or shoot things. But what you do is you aim at something with your hands like that and you flick towards it like that and you can grab things from a distance. So you can grab ammo, you do puzzles with them and things like that. So with like ammo and reloading and like bits and pieces in the level, you just aim at something and flick, and the thing just flies at you, and then you catch it with your thing. It's awesome. Like, you can run out of like ammo. You can run out of ammo, drop the clip with your thing, see a clip on the side, go whoop, catch it in your hand, and then load the gun again. It's fucking great, bro. Gun show, let's go. How many gun shows today? The fuck's happening? Tekken 8 story for lore. He's addicted to steroids. No. I mean, people do get addicted to them. Like, people get psychological addictions to them. That's what it is. People get psychological addictions. You don't really get a physical, like if you come off of a drug, you would like have withdrawal or whatever. You don't really have withdrawal from steroids. You have like a hormonal crash, but it's not the same as withdrawal. It's not really the same thing. But that does happen if you come off them. But for the most part, the addiction is psychological, I think. Guys get addicted to, like, and they get fucking body dysmorphia with it and think that they look tiny. You talk to even the guys who are like literally Mr. Olympia, like, think they look small when they look in the mirror. Or I remember this thing of Chris Bumstead, the guy who's like the classic physique Mr. Olympia. And he's like 250 pounds and he's like, oh, skinny. He said something about having fucking skinny little arms or like little biceps or something. And it's like, bro, you literally stand on the stage, they look at all your bodies and they go, you're the best. And they give you a trophy that says, I'm the best. And he still thinks that his arms don't look good. Because you just get too into it and you judge yourself so weirdly. And you've got to try and not be like that. And just live for the moment and just be the best you can be. So I think that's why people get addicted to taking them, probably. Because they just get addicted to how they look, and it's like their whole personality, I guess. You know? I mean, I definitely felt it a little bit, but because I don't use a fuck ton of fucking steroids and don't blow up massive and then shrink back down, I stayed on TRT. I don't really have that same thing when I come on and off. I'm just slowly trying to get bigger. But definitely, especially the guys who are young and use them, and then they don't use them for a bit, and they come off and they look smaller, and they're all fucked up, and they think, I want to be as big as that again. And they just keep going, and then it's basically a lifetime commitment, like I said. Once you start down that road, it's basically a lifetime commitment, probably. For most people that are serious. That's why, like I said, I went to work, finished at 11. Oh, God. Had a change of clothes, but went in the gym stinking. This is not that bad. Went in the gym stinking, and did a shoulder workout. And shoulders felt fucking annihilated, and I feel achy as fuck. But so what? That's how I want to live my life. That's what gives me enjoyment. That's what I take pleasure in. And doing streaming, and doing family stuff and whatever. These are the things that I enjoy. But I'm not chasing it for, like, you know, really at the moment, insecurity or nothing like that. It's just because that's how I like doing stuff. Big Roach really used to weightlift? Nah, he probably did it for like 6 months or something. You know, like when you're young, you go for a stint of like going out for a run or doing bench press with your dad or whatever it is. It's just that most people find other things in life. But no, I don't think he did at all. Probably like I said, he probably like one summer, he went over to his mate's house and did bicep curls every day. Like literally, that's when he says, like, here's the lift. He means a scenario like that. One summer, him and his mate in their garage, like let's say 10 times, did bicep curls and like push-ups. That's what he means. Yeah. How is it a waste of time? How is it a waste of time? He hasn't had to apply it. So Some things are, but DSP hasn't had to apply, so how would he know? Like, just because, like, when I did a PT course, a load of stuff on it was a waste of time. But that doesn't mean the PT course was a waste of time. Because even if the information is half trash, you're still going to learn about yourself, because you always learn something about yourself when you're learning new things, you're learning some new endeavor, especially as you get older. You're going to, like, either meet people that are going to teach you something. Whenever you're doing anything like that, or you're putting yourself out there in a situation, often you meet people that have got more knowledge than you. That stuff is rarely a waste of time. Like, if you're talking about, like, growing as a person and all this sort of shit. I mean, some stuff is, you know, some jobs and that, or like data entry, or some things are just like tick box requirement type deals. Oh yeah, I remember that. I think that might be on YouTube, that stream. That was when I was doing one of my home workouts. I remember that. Yeah, they all turned up. Yeah. Well, I'm not only am I super cool streamer guy, I'm not a stereotypical dad. Let's be honest. I don't think I'm a stereotypical father, really. I don't look like the other dads in the playground. The pink hair probably does it. But why would you want to be one of those sheep? Those pussies. I don't. Oh. What's the time? How much time we got? I kind of need to check that. I could play Crysis for a little bit, couldn't I? Let's see. Oh, I've got to drag the camera. Hang on. Ah. Ah. Don't do that to me. Okay, that also works. Yeah, you can be, a roided pink sheep, yeah. This is also true. Right, let's just check this out. Let's play Crysis for like 20 minutes. Right. Right. Fucking trucks and all sorts. I didn't plan to play a game at this point, but we're going to. I didn't plan on playing a game, but we're going to. Just for a little bit. Just for a little bit. Fuck changing the directory. I'm here now. I'm here. I'm sitting over a bit, but I don't give a shit. We might kill the music for this game, though. Because there's cool music in the game. This is turning up a bit.
Achieved with CryEngine.
And it doesn't say achieved with CryEngine 3 anymore. Not cool. All right. Let's see if I can remember the controls and not press the wrong thing for the armor and or the suit. Here we go.
Oh, shit. They're in the lab.
Oh.
Get in there before they find anything. I'm counting on you, Prophet.
Infiltrate the warehouse. Destroy evidence of Gould's whereabouts. Tactical options available.
Okay, we're gonna be stealth. Even though there's a sniper rifle right here. No one saw. Someone saw? Okay. I don't think anyone saw. I don't think anyone saw. We're gonna get enemy back. If I even peek out, people see me. What we got there? Secure. Ledge grab. Objectives over there. All across those docks. Fuck that, we're going that way. That way's much better. Much better. You get energy. Oh. Oh, shit. Oh! Look at these dudes just coming out the woodwork. Fuck! Oh my god.
Defensive positions. He's coming this way.
All units, we have a confirmed sighting of Prophet. He's at the pier.
Fuck!
Get that fucker down!
He's seen me! Bro, I don't want to get seen. Takes the piss. Bro, do you see how good that AI is? What's it like? I'll tell you what it's like. I swear the enemy is better than they used to be. Or if it's not, modern day AI, Shomba, needs a fucking a wake-up call. Because some of the fucking AIs are shit hot. Like, if you get spotted at all, it's over. Oh, you can shoot a suppressed pistol and stay in the cloak. Or does it just take more ammo? Oh, no, it just takes energy, okay. Some guns will break the cloak completely. I don't know if they changed anything, by the way, Shomba. I mean, it feels the same. Like, it feels good. It's definitely still fucking good. Maybe we got... So we got the docks, or we got that way. And there's fucking enemies everywhere. If I kill him... What about the water? We can swim, but I've got to get up somewhere, and it's probably going to be bait getting out of the water. These dudes turn up regardless. What's his patrol? Trouble is, I don't know how high this wall is, and there's guys all over this. So if I have to uncloak, like, there... One person sees me, I'm in the middle of all of it. Just think about it. Alright. Brain scar, we're gonna grab this because it's got a different scope on it. Grab this because it's got a different scope on it, and it's going to allow me to change out to that new scope now if I want. I think we're safe to uncloak here. We are. Is he just going to stand there? And they'll see the body. That guy will see the body if I... Fuck me! Bro! They've got it locked down so tight. Okay. New plan. New plan. See, he half went to shoot me right there, but I didn't get an alert. The AI is proper, like, squirrely. It might be because of the difficulty, because it's on veteran. It's not the hardest one. The hardest one's called Super Soldier. And I definitely beat this on the hardest setting. But I don't know if that's like a new one that they've added, so I didn't pick it. This is Crysis 2. Can we uncloak here? I think we can. Stealth! Stealth, lads. Oh, there's no suppressor on this. Fuck! How have I not got a suppressor? Well, that's why I got the sniper rifle. I'd rather have the pistol though, than the ranged SCAR. Especially seeing as the pistol you can stay cloak. Okay, we're creeping. We made it round the excessive amount of troops in there. Right. Sneak in. No one's seen. No one sees. Still no one sees. There's no dudes. How are we getting in here? Oh, I'll get on the roof or something. Andrew. Come out of the... Oh, there's two. Did I kill two of them with one shot? No, I can't kill two of them with one. That's not going to happen. It's got to be this guy. I'm pretty sure I just got a checkpoint, but I don't want to load it in case I have to do all that sneaking again. I didn't have the suppressor on the gun. I mean, it doesn't matter too much. They didn't see me.
You okay?
Can I?
Positions. He's coming this way.
Whatever.
Wait.
That was accidental. Yeah, I knew I got. I did get a checkpoint right here. I knew I did. Oh, nice. Right, back to my plan. He's gonna come look for the body. Essentially.
Oh, shit.
He's dead.
Ah! You alright? We've got a
KIA. Search the section. See, he don't know. He didn't know. He just saw the bodies dead. But I'm gonna run out of sniper ammo quick. That is an issue. I need to get a suppressor for this. I can't believe. Have they really not got. Oh. I didn't realise there was one more. It could have gone tits up. It could have gone bad. Luckily, I grabbed him. Luckily, I grabbed him and it was over. It could have gone bad. Wolf guy must have come from around here. Now, he's on a mounted gun and everything, that guy. Look at this shit. Right.
All right, I've got you on the security cam. Look, there are three guys up there. Drop them before they find anything.
I really haven't got a suppressor for that.
Get those terminals booted up. Lockhart wants copies of everything.
Okay, we've got the first victim here.
Man, look at all this stuff.
This guy's gonna see me if I kill this guy.
How the hell did he get this past Hargreave?
Gould's smarter than he looks. Hargreave wouldn't have hired him otherwise. It's not the squid I'm worried about. It's profit.
He's gonna see me as soon as I grab this dude. I can like grab him and throw him at him. But I don't wanna do that.
Tell us where he is.
Emerald section, I want reports. Where is that stupid fuck?
It's Emerald. Do you copy?
Then we good. He said three, right? He said three, pretty sure. Guns did he have? Good guns.
Crash that terminal and get out of there, Prophet. I saw a chopper heading your way. You have to move fast.
Well, just shoot him. What do you want me to do? Just shoot him. What?
A 0-1. Your target is in the warehouse lab.
Right.
Now take him out.
Understood, sir.
Am I in trouble now? Got a shotty. Ammo for the sniper rifle too.
Defeat the cell gunship.
Oh shit. They are in trouble. Bro, that's a headshot! The fuck? Bro, they were headshots! Come on, son! What was that? I lit him the fuck up! Come on now!
This is
finally, he's dead!
We have a gunner down! We're pulling out!
Maybe I could have destroyed the building. The chopper? Look, who knows? Who knows? We won! That's like the better pistol, I think. Can they come for me now? Oh. Oh yeah, dude's come through the build, through the roof. Who's coming to the building now?
He's coming this way. All units, we have a confirmed sighting of.
Where are they?
He's at the pier. Take that fucker down!
Cell gonna come in here now. I don't know how many. I was too busy twitching. Oh. Oh, this is not good. We've got to be careful if the guys drop it in as well. Fuck you. Get fucked.
Sustained some heavy damage. We're bailing out.
I don't know if I could have destroyed that, but who cares?
Prophet, get out of there. Those bastards are going to put you at the bottom of the river.
Okay. No more ammo. Right, well, we've still got plenty of sniper rounds. Well. Get out of here. There's still dudes hanging around. Still do the fucking. He came in. Where'd the other guy go? They're still throwing grenades and shit. There's loads of them still. Fuck. He's running. I did not see him. He's not dead. Oh my god, I'm out of bullets. I'm out of bullets. Oh my god, I'm literally out of everything. Yeah, okay. Just chill. There's dudes everywhere. I'll grab a shot in a sec. I can't really do that right now. Just chill out, Sue. Oh my god. Oh, he's right there. Yeah.
Oh, man. You're still there. Thank God.
Well.
Listen, I'm sending coordinates to the suit. It's not far. I've got a cradle set up here, too. Superannuated Crynet stock. Took it out of storage when I quit. It's not as powerful as the one in the lab, but it'll have to do.
Can we take another gun now? Have we just got the rocket launcher? No idea. Okay. Okay, I guess. Bro, that was an intense fight. I knew there was a big fight in there. I didn't remember it getting that crazy. And we nearly died right at the end. The way out is...
It's right across the flood barrier. Come on,
oh,
man.
Oh, bro, this guy just doesn't chill, does he? Does he not? Oh. Excuse me. I think the dude is close and we do some stuff. Oh, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm wrong. Oh no. Oh. Oh. Maybe I was wrong. I don't see enemies. Enemies everywhere. What's the time? It's clear. Look at all that. It's clear. They're going that way. It's clear and they're going that way. Low energy. Fun. God, he's right there. Please let me get away with this. We got away with it. We got away with it.
Do you copy?
I think. Oh, that's got a padlock on the door. So I've got to take this guy out. Or, like... regardless, if I hit the door, he's gonna know. They're gonna find the body. So they get more freaked out, but they don't know where I am. He's looking for that dude. He's looking at him. I think that's all of them. I don't think I could have done that with the guy standing right there. I don't think he would have liked it.
Okay, good. You're there. I'm gonna send the elevator down for you.
If you're like tattooed, basically, we're gonna do this bit.
Man, you wouldn't believe the shit that's gone down in the last 24 hours. Barclays guys are getting creamed uptown. Crynet are falling the fuck apart everywhere else. Chaos.
Prophet, man, I'm glad you're here. Waiting's been creeping me out. Come on in, quick!
Come on, bro.
Let's get these doors locked again. That shit you absorbed at the crash site. It's lit up the suit systems like a pinball.
Now he's gonna find out I'm not a prophet.
Same base structure as the nano.
Well, I mean, I am, but I'm not. Bro, like, open window right there.
So, yeah.
Oh, I made that creepy cat face into an email as well.
Of you know who. Some fucked up shit, right? And Hargreave. Well, who knows what's going on in his head?
Connection established. Please stand by. Systems online. Initialization complete. Accessing memory.
See, look.
Nano protocols engaged.
Strange.
Scanning primary.
This doesn't... Wait a... You're not Prophet!
Threat detected.
What is this? Who are you? Did Hargreave send you here to...
Unzipping embedded memory.
Find gold. It's all I can do now. You are all I can do. They used to call me Prophet. Remember me.
There you go. Yeah, it is cursed. I couldn't think of a better name for it, really. Or I just, to be honest, I just thought the name was perfect.
Find gold. It's all I can do now. You are all I can do. They used to call me Prophet. Remember me.
Transmission terminated. Primary systems rerouted. Clear to proceed.
Okay.
Jesus, I can't do this anymore. I'm not some spec ops hard man like you, like Prophet was.
What does he want, dude? He's got scanning stuff.
I'm a geek conspiracy nut, for Christ's sake.
Alien shit.
God damn it! Prophet was supposed to get us out. The Marines were coming for us. Now... Know anything about cephalopods?
Yeah, look, the ceph.
Dumb question, right? Of course you don't. Well, you want the dumbed down version? We're getting our asses kicked out there. By calamari. You ever wonder what the Aztecs and the Incas felt like when they saw smallpox for the first time?
Mushroom,
I mean, you see the spore, right?
See what it does. Thing.
Prophet kept saying he'd found an answer. That's not
calamari.
This has got to be.
Alien tissue vector.
All right. Look, that suit you're wearing. It's built out of a self-repairing, semi-organic nano-weave patented by the Hargreave Rash Corporation.
Yeah, but the suit is more special
than
that. I can't remember.
Shroom
Dukem, how you doing?
Prophet was Spec Ops. Hargreave recruited him to wear the suit, but he went AWOL.
Yeah, this is all the first game
some
stuff.
Semi-sane shit. And then...
I remembered more about the suit.
That's a viral subroutine running in the suit's deep layers. It's like living code, and it's... I don't know. It's like it's rewriting itself to accommodate something new. A fresh data pile, maybe. My best guess? What you're looking at there is the biocoding for some kind of vaccine.
The suit's making the vaccine.
Against the spore. We have to get that stuff decoded. And I can't do that here.
God, bro.
I just don't have the processing power. I need
I feel so fucking tight today. This is Crisis 2. Yeah, it's alright.
We're just going to hide him just chatting today. I'm not taking long. The vaccine, Perez, right?
The prism.
Dear me, mate.
And that's miles uptown. It'd be suicide trying to get there right now with the Zephyr. Shit! They're here! Shit! Shit!
Got it. Where did he go? Oh, they're there. Why can't I shoot? Why can't I shoot?
Tactical options available.
Where are we going, Gold? Where are we?
There's no
All clear. False alarm.
Clear.
False alarm.
Is he coming? No. You're gonna walk to the door? There, no. You don't know. Oh, you don't know. You don't know.
Huh?
He knows. See that? Did you see that? See that shit. Stealth! Oh! Where'd we go? We survive. Four rounds in our rifle, that's it.
I'm seeing a lot of cell activity on the streets around the command post. Looks like the Ceph have got him spooked. Keep right. Heading for the church. I'll see if I can help you bypass security.
Right. We might play some more of this later. Bro, are they like infected? I can't kill these people. They're just all spored up. No, we can't kill them. Wasted a bullet though. Pretty sick. Right. Right. That's it, lads. Just a little short, sweet. What we got here? Just a little short, sweet. I'll tell you who we got. I'm sorry. I've got to go out. I've got to go out. I'm afraid. I might play some of this later. Another couple of hours, maybe. Another couple of hours. I'm running. I'm going to turn it off. I'm going to turn it off before I play more. I've turned it off. It's off. It's off. It's done. Kojima World Order, I see you. Yeah, that was nice, wasn't it? Just a nice little hangout. Oh, bro, I'm aching so much. Oh, I'm aching so fucking much, dude. Maybe I won't. Maybe I'll go to bed later. Maybe I'll go to bed later. We'll see. I didn't carry that much heavy stuff. I've got to do my washing as well. It's okay. There's time to do everything. There's time for me to do everything. But maybe, if you're lucky, I'll come back later and play some more Crysis. Maybe. We need 1287, I haven't got time. I'll leave this tab open. It's a dog thing. Pretty cool. Dog hanging on the thing, that's pretty good. That dog's crazy. Those two dogs are crazy, yeah. Are hanging on the thing. I advise everyone to go and look at that. Ah, it's over. Fuck.